Hello, welcome to the Conics section, YouTube live session today. So those who have just joined in, please type in your name in the chat box so that I know who all are attending this session. All right, guys. So today's session, we are going to start with the fact that why at all Conics sections are known by the name Conics sections. Okay. So Conics section is basically given the name because they have been obtained by the section of a right circular double cone with a plane, right? So these conic sections, they are obtained by the cross section of a right circular double cone, by a plane. Okay, so depending upon how these planes or how this plane passes through the right circular double cone, different conic sections are generated. Now, what is the right circular double cone? A cone which has got, let me explain this to you first. A cone is basically, right? The right circular double cone is basically a structure like this, where this is called the axis of the cone. So this line is called the axis of the cone. Okay. And these two lines are known as the generators. When the axis of the cone makes 90 degrees with the base of the each cone, we call it as a right circular double cone. Okay. So I will now show you how basically these conic sections are generated. Okay. So let us focus on, this structure. So I can, as you can see on your screen. Okay. So basically this is nothing but a right circular double cone. Okay. So I've shown it in a 3D structure. Okay. Now this right circular double cone, if I cut it by a plane which is perpendicular to the axis, right? As you can see here, I've cut it by a plane which is perpendicular to the axis. The cross section area from the top you can see is that of a circle. Okay. So the cross section area that you can see is that of a circle. Okay, if you cut it by such a cone or such a plane which is making some angle, okay, then you realize that you start getting different types of conics. Okay, in this case you end up getting a hyperbola, right? So these basics are all clear in your mind. And if there is any question regarding the basic of creating a conic section, please do ask. In fact, I will quickly brush you through. So when you cut this by a plane, whose angle with the axis, let's say I call the semi-vertical angle of this right circular cone as alpha. And let's say this angle is theta. Okay, the angle of between the plane and the axis is theta. If theta is 90 degree, it generates a circle. Okay, and if this plane passes through the meeting point of these right circular double cone, the circle would be a point circle. Okay, if this theta is somewhere between 0 to alpha to 90 degree, it will create an ellipse. It will generate an ellipse. Okay. Again, here I am assuming that it is not passing through the meeting point of the generators. Okay. If theta is exactly equal to alpha, that means the angle made by the plane is parallel to either of these generators, the cross-sectional area left would be that of a parabola. Okay. And if theta lies between 0 to alpha, then it would end up cutting both the naps. These are called naps. Okay. Both the naps of this right circular double cone. And you will obtain a hyperbola in that case. Okay. And if it passes through the meeting point, if it passes through P, if the conic section passes through, or if the plane passes through P, if the plane happens to pass through the point P, then in that case, we call the conic generated as a degenerate conic. Okay. And pair of straight lines is an example of a degenerate conic. So first, I will spend some time on the degenerate conic in order to explain you what is the general form of the equation of a conic section. So let's talk about pair of straight lines briefly. What's a pair of straight lines? Pair of straight lines is basically a kind of a degenerate cone where you obtain the equation of this pair of straight line by multiplying two lines. Okay. So if you start by multiplying two such lines which are passing through, let's say origin, y equal to m1x and y equal to m2x. Okay. If I ask you, these are the lines which make that pair of straight lines, then the combined equation of the pair of straight lines would be y minus m1x times y minus m2x equal to zero. Right. So this is the equation of a pair of straight lines which is passing through origin. Which is passing through or intersecting each other at origin. So both the straight lines are passing through the same point, origin. Okay. If you clearly look at this expression, it's very important for you to appreciate that this expression will be a homogeneous expression in x and y. Okay. So we call this as a homogeneous function or homogeneous equation in two variables. This is going to be a homogeneous equation in two variables. Of degree 2. Of degree 2. So what is a homogeneous equation? A homogeneous equation is basically an equation where you would realize all the variables are having the same degree. For example, x square, y square, x, y, they are all having the same degree. Okay. So any second degree equation which is homogeneous in nature in two variables, that would always represent a pair of straight lines passing through origin. This is very, very important. So always remember this. Any equation of this nature, ax square plus 2hxy plus by square, will always represent a pair of straight lines passing through origin. Now, it is not necessary that both the lines would be real in nature. It may happen that you may also end up getting non-real lines as well, right? You may end up getting imaginary lines as well. That depends upon some relationship between H, A, and B that I will discuss with you later on. Okay. Now, taking a clue from this, you would realize that any conic that you see is going to be having a general formula or the general equation as ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Right? This is the general structure of any conic section that you would come across, right? Which is called a second degree general equation of a conic section. So even your straight lines, as you can see here, the homogeneous equation itself is basically is a second degree equation. Even circle, parabola, ellipse will have these six terms appearing. It's not necessary that all of them will appear together. It may happen that some of them may be absent. Now, why is this a second degree equation? Guys, if you see a very specific case from the example which I cited a little while ago, the equation of if you see the equation of a cone I've taken passing through the origin as z square equal to x square plus y square, right? So this is the equation of the cone, okay? And if you take any line, any plane, okay, let's say I take this plane x plus y plus z equal to 1, okay, and you try to eliminate your z from these two equations. So from the plane equation and the cone equation, if you try to eliminate your z, okay, you would realize that, let's say this was the equation of the cone, okay, and let's say this is the equation of the plane, any plane, okay. So I'm taking just a simple example of a cone and a plane. If you try to eliminate your z, that means replace your z with 1 minus x minus y in this, you yourself would see that when you square such terms, you'll end up getting some terms in x square, some terms in y square, you'll see some term with xy, you'll see some term in x, you'll see some term in y, and you'll see a constant, isn't it? So that is what we are trying to state in the previous slide, that any conic section would have this kind of a structure. Sorry, this kind of a structure. Ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Right? So far, any questions with respect to this? Okay, so this is the general structure of any conic section. Okay, now depending upon your values of A, B, and C, A, B, H, G, F, and C, this conic section can represent various things. Right, so now we'll discuss the condition to represent various conics, condition to represent various conics. The first condition that I'm going to talk about, that's a very important condition. If AX square plus BY square plus 2HXY plus 2GX plus 2FY plus C equal to 0 has to represent a pair of straight lines, if it has to represent a pair of straight lines, then an expression delta, which is given as ABC plus 2FGH minus AF square minus BG square minus CS square will be equal to 0. That is, in a simpler form, the determinant made by these terms will be equal to 0. Right? Now, first of all, I will prove how this condition comes. So let us prove how this condition comes. Okay. So let us start with the fact that let ax square plus by square plus 2hxy plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 represent a pair of straight lines. Okay, let's say this represent a pair of straight lines. Of course, since this is not a homogeneous equation, that means their point of intersection of these lines is not origin. Because had it been origin, these three terms would have been absent, right? So let's say this pair of straight lines, intersect each other at, x1, y1. And we are assuming that these lines are also not parallel to each other. Okay. Then do one thing. Then apply the concept of shifting of origin. Shifting of origin to x1, y1. That means I'm assuming the point of intersection now to be my new origin. Okay. So when we do that, all of you remember the concept of shifting of origin, where you replace your x with, capital X plus x1 and y with capital Y plus y1. So this was the concept which we had discussed in the beginning of the coordinate geometry chapter in class 11th. So when you do these replacements in your equation given to you, you get something like this: ax plus x1 square, okay, by plus y1 square plus 2h x plus x1 y plus y1 2g x plus x1 2f y plus y1 plus c equal to 0. Okay, and if you simplify this, you are going to see something like this: ax square by square 2hxy, and apart from that you will see terms like I'm collecting terms having capital X in it. So 2AX1, I will see. Then from here, I will get 2HY1. Okay. And I will also get term like 2G. Similarly, if I collect terms containing capital Y, I will get 2BY1, I will get 2HX1, and I will get 2F term, correct? And if I collect the constant terms, I will get AX1 square, BY1 square, 2HX1, Y1, 2gx1 2fy1 plus c equal to 0. Okay. Now, all of you please listen to this very, very carefully. If you want this pair of straight lines to pass through origin, it is passing through origin, then it is very clear that it has to be a homogeneous equation. And if it has to be a homogeneous equation, That means this term, and this term should be zero. Remember, I discussed with you, any homogeneous equation of second degree is basically representing a pair of straight line passing through origin. And since I am shifting my origin to the point of intersection x1, y1, it means that I am assuming that these terms are going to be zero. This term is going to be zero. This term is going to be zero. And this term is going to be zero. Is that clear? Because if these three become zero, I will only end up getting this term, which is a second degree term, and hence it will represent a pair of straight lines passing through origin. So this implies we have ax1 hy1 plus g equal to 0. We have, this is x1, yeah, this is hx1 plus by1 plus f equal to 0. And guys, if you note your expression very carefully, if you note these expressions very carefully, you'd realize that you can write this as x1 into ax1 plus hy1 plus g plus this expression I'm simplifying plus y1 into hx1 plus by1 plus f, and the remaining terms would be gx1 fy1 plus c. So what I did is I took an x common from this term and one of these terms, I split it open as hx1 y1 plus hx1 y1. So I took a x1 common from this term and I took x1 common from one of these terms. So this also I split it up as gx1 plus gx1. This also I split up as fy1 plus fy1. So one of the terms, ax1, hy1, and g, has come from taking this term, and this term. Similarly, for y1, if I take y1 common from this term, and this term, I get this term. I will get this term. Okay. And the remaining terms, that is gx1, fy1, and c, I am writing it over here. Is that clear? Any question regarding this so far? Now, from 1 and 2, we already know that these two are 0. This is 0, this is 0. Correct? That means I get a third equation from here. That is gx1 fy1 plus c also equal to 0. So I get three equations all together like this. So this is my third equation. Now using these three equations, I would now eliminate x1, y1. Okay. So from this, you try to eliminate x1, y1. Okay. And how do I eliminate it? If you remember, the trivial solution concept of a system of homogeneous equation or a system of linear homogeneous equation, the determinant, if this determinant is equal to 0, okay, then this system of equation, so guys, what I'm trying to say is, you know your h, you know your x1, y1 and 1, right? They are not going to be a trivial solution over here. Okay. So if the system of equation doesn't have any trivial solution, we can say that the determinant formed by the coefficients. Okay. So basically, let me treat 1 over here if nothing is there. So the coefficient of these variables would form a determinant which is equal to 0. Right? And if you expand this, you are going to end up getting the desired result, which is ABC plus 2FGH minus AF square minus BG square minus CH square equal to 0. Is that fine? Is that clear? So this is the condition which we write in a very short form as delta. Okay. So if delta is 0, your second degree equation will definitely represent a pair of straight lines. Okay.